My name is Polycarp Muchele. I come from Kenya, and my work involves HIV prevention programs, mainly HIV identifying people who are living with HIV and AIDS in the community. That's HIV testing, linkage of those who we've identified positive, and retaining them to care, especially in terms of all the age groups that we support. I decided to come for this course because in my nature of work, I work with all aspects of the health system. So one of the courses that I did was a complex, introduction to complex health system. And I wanted to understand the health system much better, because in identifying people living with HIV and AIDS, I have to work with all the health systems, starting with the community, all the structures of the health system, to be able to be able to identify people who are living with HIV and AIDS. And also my nature of work is generally to support the means of health system. So we don't entirely work independently as an NGO, but we support the Ministry of Health to be able to be the capacity that they're able to identify people living with HIV and AIDS, link all those people who are living with HIV and AIDS to care and treatment, and retaining them in care. So coming to Cape Town to study introduction to complex health system, I wanted to understand better how the health systems work, how I can work better with the health system so that really I can be able to realize the goal of the organization, which is strengthening the health system and making the health system more responsive in the prevention program that we are doing. The other course that we did in the second week was the introduction to health policy research. And at the personal level and at the organizational level, we are involved in implementing the policies that have been developed at the national level, because we more like work in a regional level. And as in the course of implementation of the policies, there are many questions that arise. Many times the results that we get after implementing the policy are not the intended results that really the formulators of policy wanted to be. And again, we face challenges sometimes when we are implementing the policy. And I want to give an example: the implementation of maternal ART for all pregnant mothers. In the policy that we are working on is that it's supposed to be that all women who test HIV positive are supposed to be started on ART on the same day of testing. And while implementing this policy, we encounter situations where mothers will want to go and consult their partners, and they will tell you that, yes, I understand that I'm HIV positive and I need to start ART today, but I have to go and consult my husband first. The challenge with that is that the information that we report at the national level reflecting the uptake of this intervention is always low, because a big number of women will go and consult first, but eventually they'll come back to start ART. But what we are reporting, because we're supposed to report how many mothers started ART on the same day of initiating of testing positive, and it will always be lower, and it's not a true reflection of the uptake of the intervention. So really, I wanted to understand this more so that I can see how my role as a person implementing these policies, that I can do, or which research questions can I do so that I can be able to feed back to the policymaker so that maybe they can change the policy and the way they want us to implement the policies. I've liked the learning process that we've undergone during these 2 weeks, and it involved more of a group discussion, working in groups, brainstorming, thinking, coming up with solutions, which was a better learning process than a lecture method, which I believe if we were lectured on what we're supposed to do, maybe I would not have understood the concepts better, because by introducing the concepts and then allowing us to work in teams of from diverse background from different countries across Kenya and across Africa and even some countries in Asia, really helped me to see how to work in a complex system. There were so all diverse ideas that came up, which really helped us to really think on how we can better solve the health system and policy challenges that we face in my country, in my area of work, and even in Africa that we are working in. So I'm going home a changed person, because when I came here, I had my own viewpoint, the way I was viewing the health system, the way I was viewing the health policy, the engagement between of the actors within the health system. But these 2 weeks has really been able to open my eyes to look at the health system in a different way. I believe I now understand the health system much better, but being a complex, I need to continue engaging with it so that I can even understand it much better. But however, my viewpoint has definitely changed, and as I go home, I already want to do a lot of research. I know that I now have a role to play in form of doing research, even if I'm the implementer of programs. From doing research so that I can be able to better inform the policy change. The one particular area that really interested me that I want to explore more is accountability in the health system, especially the informal parts of accountability, because the formal parts of accountability, which initially I didn't know that there were forms of accountability when I came into this course, they are much more well understood. But the experiences that we have in the field is that some informal forms might have a bigger impact in the way health systems respond to health issues. So it's an area that I would like to pursue more, especially when I want to do my PhD, and also an area I want to pursue more because it directly affects the programs that we implement, that we work on. So as I go home, the question that I still have is, which other forms of informal accountability that exist? And since it's an area that is less researched, or there's not much information about it, how better can I really research in this area so that I can really be able to inform? And I believe it's an area that is going to help us. It's going to help the health systems to be able to be responsive in the health issues that most of our population face. Thank you so much, and I would like to thank the whole team. I would like to thank CHESI for giving me this opportunity, for sponsoring my stay and my education here for these 2 weeks. And I would like to thank the team of facilitators and the UWC for hosting this wonderful course. As I go home, I wish that this course could continue, and I'm going to encourage particularly the leadership that I work with, people from the Ministry of Health that we work with closely, maybe one or two more should be able to come for this course next year. Thank you so much.